Hello everyone, it's Megan from Kenhub here, and today I'd like to ask you a question. Have you ever had that panicked feeling when studying anatomy where you feel like you don't know where to find additional study tools, or for that matter, how to even begin searching for credible sources? If so, you're not alone. Every student has at some point in their studies come across the very same dilemma, and that's why in this tutorial we're going to look at how you can go about finding these additional tools, and also give you some ideas of where to find them. Are you on board? Great, then let's get started. First, you need to know what is required or what you yourself require. A good way to do that is to attend Freshers Week or Orientation Week at your university. At most universities, during Freshers Week, students receive a welcome packet that contains a wealth of information to help them navigate through their first semester. This welcome package can include, amongst other things, a class schedule or study guide, and information on all the requirements for the classes you'll be taking that semester. Orientation week can be really valuable because you should also get a tour of the library, which will likely become a staple go-to source for information during the course of your studies. We all form our own unique methods or habits when it comes to studying anatomy, but one of the most important and invaluable tools for effectively learning is attending lectures. Students often tend to skip lectures that they find boring or hard to follow, but this is a huge mistake. During these classes, you'll have the opportunity to interact with your professors and fellow students, and to ask questions if and when you're unsure of a topic. Not only this, but these lectures are often held by the same professors who'll be examining you. So be sure to make good use of this time to find out what it is that they're looking for. Another great tool that you can use to improve your studies are your professors and students in the upper years. Don't be shy about going up to your professor after class or during their office hours to ask them questions about any topics that you're having trouble with. They are a great resource to use and they can really help clarify anything you're uncertain about. After all, they're the experts. Students in the upper years who have already taken and passed the classes you're taking now can also provide great insight on how to study or prepare for exams, and they may even provide you with some of their old notes, which can be of great help. Other than attending lectures, talking to your professors, and asking upper year students for advice, using your anatomy atlas, either in print form or online, is a really important tool to aid in your studies. Some students also find the use of flashcards, either bought or self-made, very helpful. And of course, the use of an interactive online anatomy trainer such as Kenhub can really help you consolidate your learning. By using our online quizzes and anatomy training units, you get the chance to repeat what you've learned and test yourself on how well you have memorised the structures. At Kenhub, you can also move through the modules at your own pace, from basic principles like anatomical planes, all the way through to expert level content like lymphatics of the lungs. The key though is to always remember that repetition, repetition, repetition is the secret to success. Of course, along with studying anatomy, you'll need to get a good grasp of both histology and embryology too. At first, you may find yourself a bit intimidated by the myriad of microscopic structures and processes you need to learn and remember in these two subjects. With histology and embryology, the department may provide good colour pictures of things like slides online. It may also be useful to print these out in colour on photographic paper and write the name of the slide as well as all the most important information about the slide on your printout. This way you can use your printouts as flashcards to help you remember the structures. And now to answer the question of how you can gain access to supplementary study materials. That being said, the first thing you should do when looking for the right sources for your study materials is to look through your syllabus. Many lecturers and professors will provide a list of recommended reading material in the syllabus, and this can be quite useful to inform where you should begin your search for supplementary study materials. Next, check your local bookstore, check for books online as you can sometimes find great deals, and of course check your university bookstore, which will likely stock most if not all of the recommended reading material. However, bear in mind that the university bookstores can be far more expensive than shopping online. Looking for used copies of textbooks on Amazon or eBay can save you a ton of money. At some universities, it's common practice to have a book sale for students run by students once or twice a year. As mentioned, the use of online resources can be incredibly beneficial. Online student forums, where students discuss their difficulties or share solutions and information about the course, can be very useful platforms. And of course, using online materials or apps like Kenhub are also incredibly beneficial. On some intranet homepages, there exist forums where students can discuss everything from looking for a new flatmate to selling old textbooks. If you haven't had any luck at bookstores, student sales are online, these could be your solution. Well folks, that's everything. Which of these study materials will you be looking into first? Let us know in the comments below. In the meantime, enjoy learning the beautiful subject that is anatomy, and we'll see you next time. Also, don't forget to check out our other study tip videos like how to find medical information and literature.